Hello, Ambassador.
Hello, how are you, Jean? Welcome. Thank you for coming.
Good to see you. I heard there's an event to promote Argentinian wine.
It's true, there's going to be an event. The event didn't start yet, but let me take you through what is going to be the event.
Sure.
Let me introduce at this point Jason, the general manager of the hotel.
Very nice to meet you, I'm Jason.
Nice to meet you.
General manager of the hotel.
So you've been preparing for this event. What's so special about this one?
This event was decided by our ambassador. That's why we strive. It should be a very nice event today. We're going to show you how much it is beautiful today.
Okay, thank you. Thank you very much, Jason. And, I have no doubt about it.
Ambassador Alfredo is my best friend as well. That's why we have been hosting a lot of events. Please enjoy the event.
Thank you. I will do so. Yeah. Thank you. Let me take you to other parts of the event.
Sure.
So after the master class that is taking place now, we will have a lunch here. Then I will deliver a speech. After the speech, we will have a tango performance with a couple of Argentinian tango dancers. And then the event will continue and finish with a B2B presentation between Argentinians and Koreans in all this space.
I really look forward to that. Yeah. I'm actually really curious about Argentinian wine. Can you tell us more about why it's so special?
Yes, about the wines, come with me. I will introduce you an expert in wines. He's the general manager of Wines of Argentina, Mr. Mario Giordano. Please follow me, come.
Sure.
Hello, Jim. Let me introduce you, Mario Giordano.
Hi, Mario.
It's nice to meet you.
He's the general manager of Wines of Argentina. Wines of Argentina is the institution that promotes Argentinian wines abroad. And Mario is working at Wines of Argentina for almost 35 years.
Oh.
So he's a real expert about our wines. He has the knowledge of the industry. And so you can ask him any question about wines that he will be able to answer you.
So you have these events in other countries
yes.
as well.
Yeah.
What's so special about the Korean event?
We recognize to Korea is this amazing country because they know a lot for wine.
Mm-hmm.
And then we want to grow here. And then we try to start this event for promote the knowledge and promote the wines and the new. Because we have the strategy is breaking new ground. This is the message for Argentina, for Argentina abroad.
So Korea represents
Korea.
New ground for
exactly,
you.
Exactly.
Right, right.
What would you say is so special about the Argentinian wine?
Argentina wine have the one name, it's very famous, it's Malbec.
Mm.
It's Malbec is a very extraordinary variety. It's all the people want to have some Malbec. California, Australia, Chile, New Zealand, all looking for. But Argentina is the best Malbec in the world because the land, not all the people have the same land for the variety.
The natural condition.
The natural condition.
Mm, right, right. So Koreans like to pair drink with food.
Yeah.
What would be the best wine that would be most suited to a Korean meal?
I suppose you have, according to my knowledge in the food in Asia, in Korea, is the fish, is the probably the white wines is mm-hmm. very important. For example, the Torrontés is amazing combination with the fish. It's amazing.
My mouth is watering just thinking about the wines you've just talked about. Can you recommend me one?
What do you like to drink? Soft, strong?
I like sweet, not sour.
I recommend you to drink 3 or 4 glasses during the day. The first is the Torrontés. It's amazing.
Show me which one that is.
Yeah, you have 2 different Torrontés here. This Torrontés is from Salta, is the north, and this Torrontés is from La Rioja, is the north, but it's more central. And then there is very different.
Let's make a toast for Korea and for Argentina, for the wines and for Arirang.
Cheers. Very nice.
Very nice.
We have more wines for you, but now we have to start the event, and then we will get together after the event. So I hope you enjoy the event and see you after to try more of our wines.
Thank you. Yes, I'll see you after the event.
Con más de 220.000 hectáreas de viñedos, la Argentina es el país con el principal potencial de desarrollo exportador de vinos. Desde la embajada estamos trabajando para que los consumidores coreanos puedan disfrutar de más opciones de nuestros excelentes vinos. Good to see you again, Jean. And I think it was a good event and interesting the meeting with Mr. Giordano and the general manager of the hotel.
Thank you very much for taking time out of your busy schedule to meet with us. The wine tasting event was really big. I was quite surprised. Is it held every year?
It's held every year. Now there was it's the ninth time we held this event. It was interrupted for 2 years. But now we are restarting the event. So, but it's the ninth time we do this event here in Seoul.
The wine market in Korea is growing. How does Argentina evaluate Korean market?
Yes, the Korean market is a very important market for Argentina, and the Korean market is growing in wines. I believe Koreans are going to drink more and more wine, and every year we are doing one or two events to promote our wine here in Korea.
Mm. Have you tried traditional Korean alcoholic beverages like makgeolli or soju?
I have tried the soju.
Did you like it?
I like it. I am not a big consumer of alcohol, so I don't know very much, but finally I like it.
So how are the Korean alcoholic beverages doing in the Argentinian market, do you know?
Yeah, I know that the soju is known in Argentina. It sells in the restaurants or in some market, Korean markets. So I believe they are doing well there in Argentina.
Right. We started the interview discussing the wine market. Let's talk more about you. How long have you been in Korea?
I've been in Korea 7 months. I arrived last April. And have been very intense, the work we have been doing here at the embassy. And I am joined Seoul. It's a very, very nice city. The landscape is very nice, and it's a city that everything goes smooth, in order. So I like very much that.
What was the first reaction when you were told that your next posting is going to be Korea?
I was very enthusiastic. It's my second posting in Asia, and I really believe economic axis of the world is in Asia. So I know that Korea was going to be a very interesting challenge for me as a professional. And I have confirmed that during these 7 months. The challenge is very big here.
Tell us a little bit about your challenges, if you can.
Yes, I believe that the challenge in Korea is to develop a very mature relation between the two countries. Today, the relation is a very low point. And very much concentrate in some agricultural products. So there is a important space for other kind of businesses, as artificial intelligence, as small and medium enterprises, startups. So there is a large variety of different activities we can develop here in Korea.
Mm. Do you find anything that are similar between Korea and Argentina?
Yes, I believe that we have similarities in the interest for culture and sports. Here, the culture is very important. Even in Argentina, Korea has opened a very important cultural center. And also, as in Argentina, sports is you have a lot of interest for sports, as we have. These are important similarities, I believe.
Is that soccer that you're talking about?
I'm talking about soccer, football in Argentina. Here you have baseball, but you have interest for football, for golf. There is a passion for golf in Korean. I believe almost 10% of the population plays golf here. So the interest for sport is very important.
Yes, indeed. Other than what you've already mentioned, Argentinians and Koreans also have something else in common. They both love films. I heard you're a movie fan yourself. Tell us more about your love for film.
Yes, I am a very important fan of promoting the film industry, as we have opened a cinema inside the embassy. We call the Mirta Legrand Hall. Mirta Legrand is a very important actress and TV presenter today in Argentina. And we have once a month, free for everybody, we show Argentinian films. The film industry in Argentina has a long tradition and is very, very important, very powerful, no? Specifically in South America.
Mm. You talked about the movies that are screened. Is there a special standard when you select the film?
We try to have an interesting diversity of films, action, drama, comic, so the public can see the different aspects of the Argentinian film industry. I have the Secret of Your Eyes is a film that has won an Oscar. Argentina won 2 Oscars, the film industry.
Wow.
So I believe this film is really very interesting. We are going to show it very soon in our cinema.
Korea has grown into quite a large film market. There are hit films that reach 10 million viewership when the total population is about 50 million. Is Argentina also a big film powerhouse in South America?
Yes, Argentina is a big powerhouse. As I told you, we have 2 Oscars and 3 nominations for the Oscars. So I believe people enjoy going to the cinema, and there is a important support from the government to the filmmakers.
Mm. Why does the government support the film industry?
Well, because the film industry, I believe, is part of the culture, it's a way and an expression to see and to show Argentina through the film industry, no?
Right. Are there Korean movies that have done well in Argentina?
Parasite, the last movie.
Have you seen the movie?
I saw the movie now in the plane. Yes.
Did you like that?
I think it was creative and passionate. Yes. I think it's a very good movie.
Yes. Can you recommend some Argentinian movies that you've enjoyed?
Yes, I enjoy very much Wild Tales, The Secret of Your Eyes, Miss Mary is an old film, but I enjoy it very much. The 3 of them are very different, periods, different histories. Wild Tales is a movie in different tales, but all they are close to our reality. Mm. The Circuit of Your Eyes is a movie of the time of the militaries in Argentina, and Miss Mary is the life of the people in the country in the early 1900s. So these are films that I can enjoy and recommend.
Yes, yes. We can't leave out tango when we talk about Argentina. It seems tango represents Argentinian culture and sport, similar to Korea's Taekwondo. Are there any programs to promote tango carried out by the embassy?
Yes, we have opened a tango academy 3 months ago. It's in the Astor Piazzolla Hall, a very important tango musician from Argentina. And we have organized this academy in partnership with the Korean Tango Cooperative. It works once a week, every Monday, and it has two different times. One is for beginners and one is for intermediates. And we see that the number of dancers is growing week after week, so really we are very happy with the idea.
Okay, so the numbers are growing. Have you had any kind of reaction from the Koreans that have been participating?
Well, they are very enthusiastic because they continue going and some others...
And the numbers are increasing?
The numbers are increasing. So, they must be happy. If not, they stop to go, no? So, I think this will contribute to the knowledge of the two countries, no? The cinema, the tango contributes to the misknowledge of the two countries.
This is more of a philosophical question, but why do you think tango developed in Argentina?
Tango was part of our life. If you see tango, the history, the story, is tango is sad.
It
is very sad, yes. The dancers are like telling all their pains through the tango. And at the beginning, tango was danced between men in the early... and 1900 in Buenos Aires. So it's part of the development of the history of Argentina.
We talked about more and more Koreans taking up tango. Why do you think Koreans like tango?
It's the passion for the culture, for the diverse culture. You asked me about the similarities between Korea and Argentina. Culture is one of them. So I believe they have interest to learn about different cultures, and through the dancing, in this case tango, I believe they try to learn more about a different culture like the Argentinian one.
Right, right. Do you think passion is another common denominator?
Yes, passion to dance tango or to dance any kind of dance, you need to be a passionate. There are very few dance without that they don't have passion, no?
Right.
Passion and tango, you have to add to the tango the sensuality. Yes. Tango is very sensual.
Yes, indeed. We'll take a look at the more serious issues now. Korea has been conducting FTA negotiations with Mercosur. Do you expect the deal to be reached next year?
It will depend in the next round in February 2020 in Montevideo. There we will be able to see if next year we will reach the FTA. Mm-hmm. I believe we have to wait until next round.
If a deal is reached, what's the benefit of the deal?
It will be instantaneously an increase of commerce and investments, probably even in both directions. It will be, in general, a facilitation of trade, commerce, and the relation will be more intense than it is today. Mm.
Argentina has abundant mineral resources, and Korea is focusing on lithium. What presence does Korean companies have in Argentina?
There is a very important Korean company in Argentina, and is in the business of extraction of lithium, and they are exporting the lithium to Korea. Argentina is, as you say, very abundant in lithium, copper, gold, silver. So we are really a natural resources abundant country. Mm. And we are working with Korea, not only for the lithium. So I expect in the near future, we can do more business in this area.
So where are we in terms of cooperation between Argentinian government and South Korean companies in terms of natural resources?
Yes, today the cooperation is, as I mentioned, this very important Korean company in terms of lithium. And now we have started working in, we want to see the possibilities in different areas. For example, in the areas of startups, I believe there is a very interesting field for and space for cooperation. Probably in the artificial intelligence, we have received the visit of our Minister of Science and Technology and have a meeting with your Minister and, of Science and Technology. It was a very successful visit. And I believe artificial intelligence and 5G are two areas in which we can start cooperation. In terms of water administration and management of water, we have also there identified a possibility of collaboration or cooperation between the two countries. So while we advance in the different areas, we can see that there are many, there is a big space for a lot of fields in cooperation between the two countries. Hmm.
It has been 7 months since you've arrived here. You must have made a lot of plans for your time in Korea. What's your biggest goal?
In terms of professional, is to really get a close relation between the two countries through business, culture, and the biggest goal is to bring different kind of delegations from Argentina in certain areas like education, like health, where I believe also there will be areas for cooperation. Mm-hmm. Is to establish a relation between the two countries that it will move alone, set areas of cooperation and working together in some alliances or strategic alliances in different areas, and then the relation will move alone. And this I think is the most important goal we can achieve here.
Have you seen any early result to the project that you've been driving?
The results we saw is that when we comment this among some authorities, they are positive. Hmm. To the idea we are and the plan we are presenting.
They're responding positively.
And for us, this is very important because it shows that we are on the right way. In terms of startups, there are some companies that are getting a little bit of results. So I believe that sooner or later, some of the results will materialize. Mm-hmm.
Finally, what do you think are some of the qualities that makes a good diplomat?
The qualities of for being a diplomat, you have to be discreet, loyal, open-minded. You have to have tolerance. I think these are qualities that every diplomat has to have. We are in a career that we are privileged because of the opportunities we have. And we learn from every part, every country we are, we learned a lot. So, these are some of the qualities or the most important qualities for a diplomat.
Thank you for inviting us today and for this great interview. I wish you all the success during your time in Korea.
Thank you very much. I enjoy this interview. I am enjoying Korea and I am sure I will have a good time here in this beautiful country. Thank you very much.
So, how do you say goodbye in your language?
We say hasta luego.
Hasta luego.
So, hasta luego. Thank you very much.
Hasta luego. Thank you very much.
Thank you.